Hello chess fans, when you see a good move, look for a better one. This was a quote from the legendary world champion Emanuel Lasker, and in this game, Fischer versus Geller, White, the great world champion from America, Bobby Fischer, exactly did this. Let's have a look. Fischer with the white pieces here. Fights against the Russian Grandmaster Geller, and we can see the material is even, but the kings are both kind of suspicious. Black attacks the white king, and also the black king is not very safe. But let's look here, white to move, and Fischer brought his queen out to b3 and also connected his rooks, and now black opened the lines against the enemy's king with h takes g. Okay, Fischer had nerves of steel and also was a world champion in calculating, and he saw, of course, the better end for himself. Now he could give a check here or here, let's say queen b4, and he would win a knight because this is forced. But a knight is just a knight. He looked for even more material and he found a better move. And this was queen b7. Before he gives any checks, he drives the rook on a8 to a worse square. In this case, the rook only can really move to d8 or e8. Let's look if he moves to e8. We simply take the rook and bring the other rook, and this is a checkmate soon. I hope you can see it. For instance, this. Okay, and if he goes after queen b7 to d8, we will see it later, because black also had in the game, and he moved this, an intermezzo check, and Fischer was of course prepared. He had his bishop. This is the only move to keep the advantage here. Otherwise the black queen would come in and hunt the king, or even checkmate the white king. Bishop g3, no problem, and even if this pawn goes forward, this white king is very safe behind the enemy's pawn. He didn't move this, he moved his rook to d8. We already saw the move, or the variation, with rook e8, and now he gives the check. Queen b4 check. And now Geller saw the disaster, resigned, game over, because now he not only loses his knight after knight e7, because white plays, of course, queen takes e7 check, and also collects the rook on d8. That's why he drove this rook to d8. And also, if the king doesn't want to get checkmated, he has to exchange the queens, and the resulting endgame is mega winning for white. Otherwise, of course, we have here another checkmate on the back rank, and we see Fischer was very precise. Let's also see if he can do another thing besides knight e7. Let's say queen d6 is not possible. We simply take and win at least the queen, and if he plays a rook d6, it's even better. We don't take the rook with check, we simply give checkmate. This way, mate in two, Another nice checkmate for white here in this variation. Okay, let's go back and look to the position after queen b3. This was the start of the precision move order, the precise move order. Queen b3, black opens files or wants to do it. And now not queen b4 check. Fischer looked for even a better move, and this was queen b7. Indeed, he didn't want to win just a little knight, he wants to win a knight and the rook. And this was, with this intermezzo, realized by rook d8, and now the check. Very precise Fischer here, because he wins all the material. The rook was lured into the danger. All the pieces are collected here, and now he can even transition to an endgame with a rook and a bishop up, if I calculate correctly. Okay, this was the nice finish of the famous game Fischer against Geller. Geller had later a very good score against Fischer, but this encounter, this was a nice victory of the American Grandmaster. And this was in the 60s, and we know 72, Fischer became world champion. He defeated Spassky in Reykjavik. And he is still a big, big chess hero for a lot of chess fans. And if you want, we look over more Bobby Fischer games and tactics and strategies and also endgames or openings. Okay, guys, thank you for watching. Subscribe, please, to my channel if you want. And we see us in the next videos. Until then, bye-bye.